In this video series, I'm introducing you to five key insights from my new book, Humanocracy, co-authored with Michele Zanini. Insight number two, there are alternatives to the bureaucratic status quo. Most of us have spent our lives in and around organizations that fit the bureaucratic template. Power trickles down, authority correlates with rank, big leaders appoint little leaders, strategy is set at the top, senior executives allocate resources, powerful staff groups set policy and enforce compliance, managers assign tasks and assess performance, employees are slotted into narrow, predefined roles. Everyone competes for the scarce resource, a promotion. This model is so ubiquitous that it's easy to believe that bureaucracy is a cosmological constant, that there's simply no other way of achieving the control, coordination, and consistency that's necessary for large-scale human achievement. Thankfully, this is not the case. A growing band of post-bureaucratic pioneers are proving that it's possible to build organizations that are as resilient, creative, and daring as the people inside them. Let me share three thumbnail case studies. Hire. Based in Qingdao, China, Hire is the world's leading appliance maker. In the U.S., it owns GE appliances. My association with Hire goes back a decade. I remember clearly my first meeting with Hire's pioneering CEO, Zhang Rumin. Looking across the conference table in my California office, he said, "At Hire, we want to encourage our employees to become entrepreneurs because people are not a means to an end. They are an end in themselves." He said, "Our goal is to let everyone become their own CEO to help everyone fully realize their potential." That was an incredibly bold aspiration. And in the years since, Hire has been working hard to prove that a big company can be just as entrepreneurial as a startup. Monolithic things aren't very adaptable, so Hire broke its 80,000-person organization into more than 4,000 independent microenterprises. Some of these are market-facing units, like an ME that's responsible for three-door refrigerators. Some are supply and service MEs that provide R&D design and manufacturing services. And some are marketing and distribution businesses. At Hire, there are only two layers between the small ME teams and the CEO. Every microenterprise is guaranteed three freedoms: the right to set its own strategy, the right to hire team members and define roles, and the right to distribute financial rewards. Hire's MEs are linked together through an internal market where MEs buy and sell services. A product ME, for example, will contract for design services, HR help, and distribution access with other MEs. Every contract has a performance clause that ties compensation to marketplace outcomes. If a product doesn't meet its goals in the marketplace, every ME supplying services will take a hit. This ties everyone's pay to the value that's created for customers. Critically, there are no internal monopolies. If an ME can't find customers, it goes out of business. Additionally, every ME team chooses its own leader. And if an ME fails to meet its targets for 3 months in a row, it triggers an automatic leadership re-election. At Hire, frontline employees have a big financial upside as well. When an ME meets ambitious growth goals, known as leading targets, team members get a big payout that can multiply their base pay several times over. Finally, Hire makes it easy for employees to start new businesses. Would-be entrepreneurs get introduced to Hire's network of venture capital partners. And if they attract funding, Hire will co-invest with an option to buy out the VC partner at a predetermined valuation. Like the typical startup, Hire's organization is flat, fast, and open. Pretty much the opposite of the typical bureaucracy. Nucor. With revenues of more than $21 billion per year, Nucor is America's preeminent steelmaker, leading the industry in both efficiency and innovation. At Nucor, frontline operators take the lead in business development, in product innovation, process improvement, and cross-plant coordination. Every employee is trained in the economies of the steel industry and participates in a generous bonus system that rewards teams that boost capital efficiency. Nucor's head office in Charlotte, North Carolina, is home to just 100 staffers, a tenth the number that work in the corporate center of U.S. Steel, America's second largest steelmaker. At just 3% of revenue, Nucor's general and administrative expenses are roughly half that of its peer group. Return on capital exceeds industry norms by 50%, with revenue per employee a whopping 3x the industry average. Birdsorg. With more than 16,000 nurses and caregivers, Birdsorg is the leading provider of home health services in the Netherlands. It is organized into more than 1,100 self-managing teams that are responsible for finding clients, renting office space, recruiting team members, managing budgets, scheduling staff, meeting ambitious targets, and improving the quality and efficiency of the care they provide. Every team has a housekeeper and treasurer, a performance monitor, a planner, a developer, a mentor. All of these are part-time roles filled by team members who spend most of their days working with patients. Birdsorg trains every associate in group decision-making, active listening, conflict resolution, and peer-to-peer coaching. Administrative personnel include 36 regional and head office on-demand coaches, 50 back office staff, mostly in IT, and two directors, including Jos de Blok, Birdsorg's founder. Thanks to this super lean structure, Birdsorg's overhead costs are 67% lower than the average for its peer group. Staff turnover is half that of similar providers, and patient satisfaction 30% higher. This is the payoff to Birdsorg's commitment to humanity over bureaucracy.